Hello, I am Thekla Petridou. It's Friday, the 3rd of July 2020, and this is our weekly video blog, aka vlog, in English. Today's subject is about obsessive compulsive disorder and how do we treat a member of our family if they have been diagnosed or suffer from that disorder. I got an email from a viewer of our channel which says, "Hi Thekla, I'm a Greek Cypriot living in Australia. I've been following you for a while now and I was wondering if one day you can cover the subject of OCD, Obsessive Compulsive Disorder. I have a family member who is suffering that I like to help. She does not seek any help as she believes she's okay with the way she is. Unfortunately, I find she became a bully towards her family and does not care even about her husband or children. It's like as if they are prisoners in their own home. I'd like to hear your opinion and recommendations for help. Thank you and kind regards." Thank you very much for the email, which gives me the opportunity to talk about obsessive compulsive disorder, which is a mental disorder that affects not only the person who has this diagnosis, but their family as well. I've had a personal experience growing up in a family home that my mom suffers from OCD. Fortunately, my mom was very positive in seeking for help, in undergoing cognitive behavioral therapy and doing whatever was possible at the time that I was growing up in order to help herself cope better with her diagnosis and having a better relationship with us, my father and my brother and me. And most possibly, this is the first reason which made me care about psychology, psychotherapy, and have interest towards the science of psychology and psychiatry. Obsessive compulsive disorder is a mental disorder that is believed to have a genetic component. Somebody gets born with a tendency towards obsessive compulsive disorder or towards obsessive compulsive personality disorder. There are two different disorders. The one is the plain disorder, which is most possibly what your family member suffers from, and the other one is a personality disorder. Obsessive compulsive disorder has several symptoms which make the life of the person who has this disorder difficult, but also makes the life of people around him or around her difficult as well. Some of the symptoms might be that person has an obsession with cleanliness. And usually they have some specifications. Not all obsessive compulsive disorder diagnosed people have the same symptoms. Some of them might care obsessively about cleaning the floor. And you might see somebody cleaning the floor of their house or their flat 3 times a day, 4 times a day, or even 2 times a day, cleaning the floor, like not just brooming the floor or vacuuming the floor, clean the floor with a vacuum cleaner, but also mopping the floor. Some other emphasize on the cleanliness of their attire. They try to keep their closets extremely clean. They use a lot of antibacterial agents. What we use now that it's the coronavirus pandemic, they used all the time. They like to disinfect the closets, the place where they put their clothes, their washing machine, their drying machine, and they have this irrational fear that if their clothes are not germ-free, something wrong will happen. Some other people get obsessed over cleaning their toilets and bathrooms, and they want their toilet and their bathroom to be disinfected and shiny all day, every day. There are people who use the toilet, and after using the toilet, they have to clean it up as we usually do once a week. Some other people might have the symptom of imposing themselves on doing some actions which are rather illogical. For example, you walk on a pavement and you try not to step on the lines on the pavement, because in your brain this might be something good. Obsessive compulsive disorder, it's an affection disorder. It has to do with our feelings and our thoughts. And people with obsessive compulsive disorder, they have obsessive thoughts and compulsive acts. Obsessive thoughts is that they think obsessively about stuff. They might all the time think, have I closed the water taps after I left the house? Have I locked the house well? A person with OCD might need a couple of, maybe 20 minutes or 30 minutes in order to be able to leave the house. I mean, after they are ready to get out of the house, they tend to come back and come back and come back and check if they close the taps, if they close the gas, if they close the electricity, if something, and they don't remember if they have cleaned or closed the house well. They might not feel sure that they locked the door, and they might come back and check again and again if they locked the door or if they took everything with them. People with OCD also, as I said before, they have obsessive thoughts. For example, they might go to church, and it's something that it's interesting, because these kind of obsessive thoughts are usually found in religious people. They might go to church and their brain might be bombarded with unethical pictures, unethical thoughts, dirty thoughts, and they, as much as they wish not to think of something that is not appropriate to think of in a church setting, they keep thinking. They keep having porn images in their mind, or they keep looking at people and imagining them naked and stuff like that, and they cannot stop this obsessive thinking. And people with obsessive compulsive disorder, they have lots and lots of guilt over everything. They feel guilty about their actions, guilty about their thoughts, and they are very, very sad about themselves. They cannot enjoy life, and they have a really great need to control their environment. No matter what variation of OCD they have, either they are germophobic, or they focus on keeping the house tidy, of keeping everything in an order. For example, had I been diagnosed with OCD, I wouldn't be able to film this video unless all the books here were in a very straight order. And even if this book that comes like this would be a problem, or this thing that comes out of this book would be a problem as well. They want tidiness in every aspect of their house. You cannot move anything. I mean, were I an OCD, a person with OCD, and somebody came here and moved this, put it here, I would feel really distressed. I would be obsessing about it. I would feel uneasy until I took it and put it where I think, or I have the obsession that it fits. People with OCD, either they are germophobic, or they want their things put in a certain way. They try constantly, from the moment they wake up until the moment they close their eyes and sleep, to control their environment, to control the material environment around them. But as well, this need for control expands to themselves as persons and to the people who live with them. And it's really, really frustrating for a person with OCD to live with children in the same house, young children that go around the house, they run, they play, they make things dirty, they might break something. And when you have children, you cannot keep your house tidy. And a person with OCD gets very frustrated and suppressed when they have children. And they might as well get very angry with their children, and they might shout at their children, they might punish their children, or even make their children feel guilty for doing natural things like playing with dirt, or like running in the house, or like bringing an animal in the house, a pet. Because some of the people with OCD, they are germophobics as well. And even though I happen to get to know some people with OCD that they love animals, they really love them, but do not allow on any pets to enter the house because they are afraid. They have this irrational fear that any pet can bring germs in the house and make them lose control. And also the partner, the domestic partner of somebody with OCD, suffers a lot because their partner all the time try to control the environment, try to control the house routines, try to control everything that goes around the house. And this is frustrating and puts pressure on their spouse and the relationship. How can you help your family member that you think that she has OCD, or you know that she has OCD? You don't specify in your email if she has gotten an official diagnosis, but you might guess from her actions that she might get the diagnosis once she is persuaded to visit a mental health specialist. There is not much you can do. The only thing you should try to do is persuade her to seek professional help. She needs to go to a psychiatrist to have her diagnosed and give her the medication that is usually prescribed for OCD, for obsessive compulsive disorder, and usually the medication prescribed for this disorder is the same like the medication described for depression, because there is a chemical imbalance on the brain of people with OCD. Their serotonin levels are really low, and the psychiatrists usually prescribe antidepressants and especially SSRIs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, which this medicine has been found to be effective on moderating the symptoms of OCD. It does not make OCD go away, but it moderates the symptoms. And first, she should go to a psychiatrist to get an official diagnosis and a drug prescription. And at the same time, she should also visit a clinical psychologist in order to start psychotherapy, so that she manages to manage her obsessions and her compulsions. Your family member will never become a person that does not try to control the environment, herself or others. But if she seeks for diagnosis and treatment, she can moderate her symptoms enough in order to be able to live a better life herself and not to impose so much pressure on her children and her husband. I'm really grateful to my mother because she had the diagnosis when she was much younger than me. I mean, I think she might be 40 years old when she got her diagnosis, and she did her treatment, and our life became much better because this gave her strength in order to manage her need for control around the environment. And it's not something that you should feel ashamed of, seeking for professional health, visiting a psychiatrist, visiting a psychologist, taking antidepressants, undergoing psychotherapy. It's something that you should feel proud of, because you realize that you have a problem, you realize that your life gets difficult from the problem, from the mental health problem you have, from the mental health disorder that makes your life difficult, and also you realize that you make your loved one's life difficult. So by asking for diagnosis and treatment, you do the courageous thing. I would also tell you or advise you to show this video to your family member, and maybe if she listens to my opinion, if she listens to my story as well that I shared with you today, maybe she understands how important it is, how crucial it is for her own well-being first and for her family's members' well-being later to seek for diagnosis and treatment. And I'm telling you again that she will never become like somebody who doesn't have obsessive-compulsive disorder, but she will moderate her symptoms enough in order to live a normal life. I wish that she listens to you and she seeks for treatment. Thank you. Have a nice weekend, everybody. We will have again a new video in English next Friday. Bye. Have a nice weekend.